Welcome back. The time is now 8:22, and these days everyone is concerned about COVID-19, and we're doing all that we can to stay safe.
But now there's something else related to this coronavirus to be careful of: COVID-19 robo-scam phone calls. So let's get some advice on how to protect ourselves from these types of calls and scams from Mike Keegan. Mike is a robocall expert. He is the CEO of Transaction Network Services. So first off, good morning, Mike. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning, Nick and Demetria. How are you guys?
We're doing great. So we all know that during these times of crisis, there always seems to be that group that kind of comes out of nowhere and tries to take advantage of people, whether it be natural disasters, in this case, a virus. So give us some of these top COVID-19 scams that you're seeing.
Yeah, we're starting to see a lot, right? Some of the top ones we're seeing today are calls related to tests or cure kits. So fake tests, fake cure kits, fake house cleaning will come to your house and clean your AC to protect your family, cheap healthcare insurance. Student loans are a big one. So there's a lawsuit been filed against your student loan. We'll waive the interest. Lots of times it comes from an organization called the Student Loan Health Center. That organization doesn't exist. Also, interest rate reductions on your credit cards, Apple Care, your iCloud account has a problem. Give us personal information so we can help you. Social security scams, such as your social security number has been suspended. We're also seeing a number of robotech scams. So one of them would be retail discounts. One of my favorites is from Costco. It's not from Costco, but get $130 worth of Costco goodies. That's our stimulus package for you as a loyal customer, a free iPhone, scams like that. There's also the IRS stimulus fund that it's a robotext that comes to you and says, hey, give us your information so we can send you the check. There's also stuff on IRS from a tax perspective. You haven't paid your taxes. Remember, tax deadlines have been extended. The IRS would not, contact you directly or threaten you in any way to make sure you paid your taxes. So, those are the top scams we're seeing today.
So obviously no shortage of those scams.
Exactly.
There's a lot of them to watch out for.
A long list. Well, we do hear all the time how senior citizens are especially vulnerable to these phone scams, but that's especially true during this pandemic, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. We did a study, and you can find it on our website, tnsi.com, if you go on and just type robocall. But, normally in today's environments, even higher, about 80%, 90% of seniors receive at least one spam or robocall a week, and over 50% receive seven. And they're particularly related to healthcare. Customer, support for your computer, your support is going out of, is expiring. Please call us back so that we can, update that for you. A lot of that is going on today, and seniors are very vulnerable to the healthcare scams.
Yeah, and they certainly are a very targeted group for sure, no doubt about that. So you have some data specifically about how widespread these robocalls and scams are right here in the Philadelphia area. Can you enlighten us on that?
Yeah, so what we saw in April, there were 70 million fraudulent calls in the Philadelphia area, and they are all related to mostly related to the scams that I just talked about.
Wow, that's a lot. That's
exactly.
A mass amount of calls, yeah.
So then, Mike, what can we do to protect ourselves then?
Yeah, I think there's a couple of things. As you're doing here, it's great. I mean, educating on the type of, spam and robocalls that exist today are important. I wouldn't pick up the phone if you don't recognize the number. I think that, in that situation, if it's a legitimate call, they will leave you a voicemail, right? There's a scam that's going on. It's called a one-ring scam. Well, they'll call you. If you don't recognize the number, don't call back, because that's a call that you'll incur charges for calling the number back. If you feel like you have been scammed, call your local enforcement. And probably the best thing that you can do is kind of go onto the website for your carrier, type in robocall in the search box, and they will give you instructions on how to download onto your phone an app. And that app will do risk scoring for calls coming in so that you can understand whether or not the carrier believes, as it's coming in, that it's a nuisance or fraudulent call. The carrier will also block calls coming to your phone if you download that app that are known robocalls.
That's definitely some good advice. Okay, so where can people go to get more information about you guys and what you do to help us out during these types of scams and phone calls, robocalls?
Yeah, so if you go to tnsi.com and type in robocall, you'll find a lot of information on the current scams and what you can do. I would also take a look at FCC.gov and type in robocall there as well. That's where the Federal Communication Commission has put out the latest information on recent scams. And again, go to your carrier, for instance, Verizon.com, and type in robocall. If you do any of those three things, you'll be educated and get more information on how you can protect yourself against these types of, you know, nuisance and fraudulent calls.
All right. Some very important advice. Mike, thank you so much for joining us.
Appreciate it. Yeah, have a great day. Stay safe
and
healthy.
You too.
Well, coming up, we continue.